are recording.
Are we recording?
Yes, we are recording.
Hello.
Yeah, hello.
What a good time.
We're at the QTH here of wb6trq, who can't seem to open his eyes. I wonder why. How can we rectify the situation?
How many thousand watts is that thing?
let's talk about this is the Prez himself, Norm Scott, wb6trq, and one of his guests here this evening, KF6EA.
Yes, that's right.
And we've come out here this evening especially to take a look at Norm Shack and to see what the Spam Prez is doing. Actually, we wanted to check up on his backlog and see if he's doing all his carrying out all his presidential duties. Do you have anything to show us as far as equipment, Norm? Perhaps your station, as for starters. Like being blitzed, right? Okay, Norm. Well, tell us a little bit about your shack. Perhaps you'd like to show us your console or your transmitters or.
Okay.
You step aside. I'll try to get everything in focus here.
This is a radio station mixing console. It's an 8-channel mono board that was used at work, and they were converting everything to stereo, so they were going to throw it out, and so I rescued it from work. And this is a console. It's a slope console, 19-inch rack panel console that all the equipment is mounted in. We'll start over here. Over in this area is the, I'm going to move my cup over. In this area is the limiters.
What kind of limiter is that, Norm?
It's a Valley People limiter. And this is a compact disc player.
Where's that? Where's the compact disc?
Right here.
What do you put that on, 20 meters?
No, actually it makes a great oscillator because there's a test disc that you can buy that gives you various tones and various white noise and all kinds of stuff you can use to test the transmitters out with. And that's what I like to use the thing for. Plus, when I'm working on something, I can turn the thing on and run it through the mixing console and listen to music while you're working on it.
In a dummy load?
Well, not even with the transmitter on. You can listen to it in the program output.
Oh, very good. Very good. That's another good reason for having a broadcast console like this.
Yeah, it's got actually two channels, an audition channel and a program channel. Up here is the EQ for the station, for the complete transmitter. What happens is the audio runs from the console to the EQ, to the limiter, to the transmitter. And it allows you to shape the audio in any manner that you want to. In the center is a regular run-of-the-mill TS-940.
Oh wow, that's not run of the mill.
Well,
that's a Cadillac of rigs.
Plenty of them around. And above that it's a Heathkit SP610 scope with a freshly marked FCC property tag inside.
And what kind of a microphonium is that? Wow.
Well, that's an RE a PL20.
PL20.
Is that
a dynamic?
Uh-huh. It's a dynamic microphone. Next to the monitor scope is a part machine, which we have a card.
Could we hear WB6TRQ Potrero?
Okay. WB6TRQ Potrero.
Yay!
So that's what we use that for. We have other ones too.
I know we've been tuned in late at night.
We can call CQ through the cart machine.
Oh, let's hear a CQ. I wish we had a lapel mic hook up here, but I just wasn't ready tonight.
Hello CQ, calling CQ, calling CQ. Hello CQ, 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 calling CQ. Hello CQ, 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 calling CQ.
That's when we first got the
WB6. I'm talking about modulation.
Radio Quebec. wb6trq calling CQ, CQ, CQ calling CQ. Hello, CQ, 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 calling CQ. From WB6Tango, Radio, Quebec.
I've been surprised.
WB6TRQ, calling CQ.
Okay, could we take a look at your big rigs in there, Norm?
Calling CQ.
Okay.
Hello, CQ, CQ.
Anything else you want to show us here?
Well, there's also in this area is a Commodore 64 and an RTTY unit, so we can run RTTY and receive RTTY. Then we basically have a cassette recorder. We can record stations on the air and play it back for them, so they can hear what they sound like. Works pretty good for rice
Fantastic.
Boxes because they can't hear themselves.
Is that a color monitor?
Yeah.
Oh wow. Oh, we could put the camera on that after a while and play this back. Let's see what is in this other room over here to the to your left.
On this side here, we've got.
Oh wow. Holy
smokes.
This is
the transmitter room.
Oh my gosh. The transmitter is so big I can't even get near it. Does that make any sense? Compared to the size of the room, the transmitter is huge. If I'm going to stay in focus, I really...
This thing right here is a Gates broadcast transmitter. It was used up until about 7-8 months ago at KOWN in Escondido. And they gave it away.
Oh, wow.
And so I drug it home and found out I couldn't get it in the house. So it was time to build another room. So this used to actually be a window right here. And so what we did is put a sliding glass door in here. And the this particular transmitter makes a lot, or linear amplifier, the homebrew one.
That's the famous 4CX, what are they?
Yeah, the house is ceramic.
The house is ceramic. 4CX 1500s?
Yeah, there's two.
A pair of them.
Two 4CX 1500s.
Thus, folks, I want you to note the nomenclature that Norm has on his transmitter. RFL 5000.
Well, it really does more than that, but...
Eat your heart out. Now, that's plate. Of course, that's plate dissipation.
Yeah.
Notice that sort of a hesitation
well,
in his voice when he says
it is plate dissipation, but if you were to take the screen voltage and turn it up to 325 volts, the dissipation would actually equate to plenty of watts on the output.
I can imagine.
With the 225 volts of screen voltage,
the lights would dim.
You get about 2,200 watts output, that's it.
Well, with the pole peg, the lights, you have your own service from the transformer.
Well, actually, the pole peg transformer that's in the bottom of this amplifier deck is bigger than the one that's outside on the pole. So if there's ever a contest, we'll know who wins.
What do you think?
SDG&E will lose.
What do you think about this, Rich? Is this really happening?
Yes, this is really happening.
Wow.
And you saw it here at WB6TRQ.
I'm impressed. I wish I had a micro-type lens, Norm.
Oh, yeah, because stuff that gets in real close, it's hard to...
It's practically impossible. Well, this is really neat. Okay, Prez. What do you have to say to your constituents out there? Now that we have you on camera, exactly where we want you.
Just keep on AMing.
Keep on AMing. Is that the state of the your state of the AM community at large wishes for the new year?
If you think 88 was great, wait till 89.
Hey, we is here.
We have just begun.
Well, thanks for having us out here this evening, Norm. We're not going to run away right away, but is there anything else that you'd like to show us while you're on camera here? That's something we should know, or something you'd like to share with some of the other guys around the country that may be getting a clandestine copy of this production here?
What was that one guy? There was one guy down at work who was a black engineer, and he was working for a public access outlet, and the guy comes through the back door and tells me he wanted some old equipment that we had, and we gave him the old equipment. I told him, well, it was broke here and broke here. And on the way out the door, all the guy told me, he says, it's all motherfucking video. So all I can tell you is it may be low level, but it's all motherfucking AM.
Hey, I didn't know he had it in him. Nothing further from KF6EA?
No, it's just impressive here. That's all I have to say. Nice setup.
We're going to have to get a copy of your interview with Leo Meyerson and get that in here, too, I think. It was an outstanding...
Where's those tapes at, anyway?
Dave Ramser has them.
Well, we need to get those.
We sure do.
Because I think he's getting ready to leave.
Oh, the area?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Oh, we should take those for sure.
You have to clean one?
Yeah, I think so. When you were sitting there one day...
Loving you like
well,
I
that
do.
Is new.
It's crazy.
Sat there and he said, I think I hear a shortwave broadcast station in the background. And I had this thing running at 10 watts while you were sitting on the frequency. He was playing some of your blues music for you.
Oh, I love it. I love it.
Boom, boom.
Boom, boom. Yay!
I'm gonna shoot you right down. We're all for your feet. Take you home with me. Put you in my house.
This is not being modulated and then taken off the air.
Oh, yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
There's no pin diodes.
You're not using the pin diode. Oh,
no.
That is stock 940 audio?
No, well,
with some EQ in front of it.
No. There's no filters in it, and there's no restriction in the audio.
But you have that EQ over there. You have your EQ over there.
Yeah, that's all working right
now.
But the 940 is using the same balanced modulator that it uses on sideband.
Okay. It's clean enough.
Some cassette player, compact disc, and then this was the output of this receiver. What I'll probably do is flip this around. So this receiver will be up here, this receiver will be here. And then what I've got it done is I've got it wired so that the Yaesu FRG7700 actually looks at the IF output of the Kenwood. So I have three positions of AM filtering I can check in or out.
Okay.
You know, conditions are real good up on 10 meters. You can open it all the way up.
Hey, Norm, you going to check in tonight?
Yeah. Yeah, it makes a noise. Huh? Well, let's see, I got a whole shack phone. This is
wb6trq. Yes, wb6trq. Evening. Yeah, we're coming and going, so I'm glad for the reinforcements. Well, we have up to 3 MLBs here. And that's the time Columbia said he's standing by.
Yeah, a bunch of other guys
are sitting on left. I'm going to have to throw someone such conditions on to the WB6TRQ and the group from the 6RNC.
Okay, friend, who gets it next?
Well,
I'll
have to
work with KAMLV
and myself.
Well, I know that Ricardo is, he loves to hang in there. Okay, well, very good, Mo. I talk out of this thing all the time. so I've got hot mics and that are in my face with the camera running. this guy is just as bad as when he's in a car. I must be it looks like headlights or something like that. Anyway, I've got KF60A is here and W6PSS, so Ricardo, you won't have to listen. Rick was telling me that he was tired of, he wondered how come he was having to keep straining all the time to listen to you on a mobile rig, and I says, well, I don't think his radios are working at home. Well, he says, he needs to get one and get it fixed. He's losing his hearing by trying to copy that mobile.
No comments.
All right, well, let me get out of this position. I'll give it to Rich. Rich, all you gotta do is just throw the switch when you get finished. There's only K8 MLV. It's real simple.
That's pretty simple. I think I can handle that even. Hello and good evening from KF60A. And what a fun thing it is to visit the Radio Shack of WB6TRQ, who utilizes all of the broadcast techniques that he knows about naturally. And I'm sitting in front of a very impressive console, watching my volume units, and watching the oscilloscope and the spectrum analyzer. And it serves as really quite an inspiration. I'll never be satisfied with a stock KW1 again. I have to get my board hooked up. I can see that. This is real exciting to have a control board. And you guys out there, you need one too. You just don't know it yet. You need to visit WB6TRQ, and then you'll be really, really inspired. And this broadcast is being videotaped by W6PSS tonight. Otherwise known
beam
as hot
overseas.
Lights. Say what?
It's being beamed overseas.
Yes. Likely to be beamed several places. Earlier we were.
How about beam me up, Scotty? Norm Scott, that is.
Yes, that's right.
Huh? Huh? Is that original?
Yeah, that's pretty original.
Hey.
I won't tell you what he said. Earlier we were doing a little bit of work up on the foreign broadcast band. That program's over now. And I'm now drinking something to settle my stomach because the WB6TRQ driveway tends to shake you up a little bit as you're coming in. But we also enjoyed a very nice fish dinner tonight out at the is that the Potrero restaurant?
No, that's the Barrett Cafe.
Barrett Cafe.
Yeah, at the Barrett Cafe.
All you can eat fish fry.
Yeah, it's a big fish dinner we had.
Burn out my batteries. Let him talk.
Well, okay. he'll burn him out on the other side.
A while?
No.
Over and talk a while.
No. Hello, Ricardo. Right. Hello, W6RNC.
Okay.
You're loud.
You only came to a minus 10 dB. Speak up, Dave.
Hello.
There you go. You're up to minus 3. That's very good. Over to you, Rick. K8MLV and the group. This is K. Whoops. This is WB6TRQ.